Saxon, prepare our forces for an all-out attack. Rook, inform the Syndicate of the invasion.
It's been a while since we had a fight like this. Are you ready?
We will be painting Gar Saxon today. We're going to start out with two different colors. Dawnstone and Scavenblight Dinge. A couple different darker grays. I'm going to do some of the base highlighting with this model as it's primarily black, but put these on your wet palette here. And you want to kind of start with either going from black to light or light from black. Either way, I'm just going to go ahead and do the lightest color, Dawnstone. And we'll start this timer. And I'm going to cover all the spots that I want to have the nice bright colors. So kind of the top of the helmet here, his arms here, maybe the side of his pants here, on those boots, and going back here a little bit. Just kind of covering the entire model where I want those lightest colors to be. You can be very messy with it because we're going to start blending our highlights in. And I'm happy with that. Let this completely dry, and we'll come back. It's had time to dry. Looks really messy. That's okay. It's bright from the top, dark from the bottom. Let's grab our paint here. Now we can grab a little bit of our darker gray and mix it in here in the middle. And feel free to mix and gradient as much as you'd like. We're just gonna go for speed and tabletop ready. Let's begin our timer. And I'm going to go around all of the light edges and kind of make it a little smaller. So here on the edges, get the darker one here. A little bit down here. And on this side here. Underneath the arms, kind of drag it down a little bit while going up onto the light gray Dawnstone. Now, I'm not sure what color we're going to do is jetpack, but I know there'll be some red in there. It's okay. We're just trying to blend as best as we can. And back here on his helmet might be a little darker. his pant legs here a little bit. Kind of spreading around that. Go ahead and get the dark gray just straight. Let's go back over here and try and mix it up with the black a little bit better. Alright, got our darker gray and lights here. Still wanting to make the model look as black as possible, but just showing, you know, where the light hits a little better. Go ahead and pause our timer, come back. Let's utilize our Abaddon Black, put that on your wet palette, and let's mix it up with this dark gray. I'm going to do some darker spots now. So just kind of focusing on the underside as much as possible. Getting these crevices where I got it too light gray. This is a nice blending in. Really works well with the actual black on the chest piece here. is trying to get in between his neck area and his helmet here with this darker mix of gray and black. Maybe the front of his helmet a little bit here. We'll go back over that in a moment. Really liking where his shading is with his legs right now. And go ahead and just grab our straight black. Come back in here. Just kind of get the darkest spots. Right. Let this dry. We've had time to dry. Let's go back over the helmet a little bit. Do some more lighter dark grays. Kind of fix our helmet a little bit. Now I'm going back over right top of the model with just that straight dawnstone and some of the shoulders here. Just to give that extra pop where I want it. Kind of have the helmet where I want. I'm going to be going over it with some more colors, so this is just the undertone. It'll make it easier for later on. Really like how it's looking right now. A little bit more on the face shield. A little bit more blending. Okay. It's much better. We'll let this dry and come back. While we're waiting for the other base to dry, I do Aberland Sunset for the visor and the chest piece. So go ahead and put that on your wet palette. Grab a smaller brush. It's all right if you get out of the lines, because we're going to be going back over with red. Because on the edges is highlighted with red. Obviously you can do whatever colors you want. We'll let that dry. Go ahead and use the chest piece here. Luckily, it's not hard to get an angle on here. Just right in here. This also has raised edges for the red to follow up on. So don't feel too bad getting out of it. Use the edge of your brush to get the other two dots up above. And if you mess up like I did just now, you can go back up with black. But those are the two triangles above the middle triangle chest piece. I'm gonna let this totally dry and we'll come right back. Let's put another coat of the yellow on. Same one. And back to the chest piece. Edge of your brush. We'll let that dry again. We're going to add some flash gets yellow and mix it in with our Avalon Sunset and go back over our visor just very steadily here. Kind of in the middle, not the whole thing. Get back some of your Avalon Sunset, come back down here on the very bottom, and go in an upward motion, and from side to side inward, to kind of have that darker yellow on the sides. I'm not going to paint the chest because it's more in shadow. So that one coat, a couple coats of Avalon Sunset, that's fine. If you want to do a little bit more of the brighter yellow in the middle of the mask, you can. Fix his helmet a little bit. I'm gonna grab some of the dark gray black mix and just kind of drag it upward here. I want to get a little blend on the front to help better match. And then I'll get a little bit of the lighter and drag it down. Just to give it that little extra blending, because I felt like it was too stark. There we go. Once that dries, it'll look a lot better. And it doesn't have to be perfect up here. If you want, you can go another layer, a little brighter. Make sure the back has it. Okay, that's a lot better. A lot smoother of a transition now. Grab a little bit of a flayed one flesh or a white. We're going to mix that in with our bright yellow. Show my wet palette here. So I mixed it in right here. So this is my brightest yellow. And we're just going to create a straight line down his visor just to give it that nice look we want. Just to show a little bit more brightness. And kind of drag it down just a little bit. Like that. It's hard to see right now, but it looks really good. We're gonna use our black and go back over our mistakes here. So right here on the chest piece, there's a little yellow spot that I wanna fix. It's hard to get to and show on camera, but there we go. And now, we're following the same color scheme. The top of his helmet visor is a black color. We're going to use the edge of our brush and highlight, I guess not highlight, but go over it with our black. Switched brushes. I was having a hard time putting the paint down. Okay, so we've got the top portion of the visor complete. And let that dry. Grab some Mephiston Red. Gonna work on the rest of the visor here. Use the edge of your brush. If we mess up, we'll go back over it with yellow once it dries. And if you are going to mess up, try to mess up on the side where the black and gray is. It's a little easier to fix, so if you're hesitant to go in on the other side of the yellow, just ease in on the darker side. Right. Looks pretty cool. Messed up a little bit on the top of the helmet and a little bit on the visor. Easy fix. Really, it's just as simple as using the edge of your brush, follow the line of the helmet with your stroke, and then turn the model and do the, get a couple different coats on there to make that really pop. Right. Let's pause this while it dries. It's had time to dry. So we're gonna go back and fix our mistakes here just real fast. Easy to do. Let's add our black here. Just get the top of the visor here. Where that red was. Like so. And now let's go our yellow. Alright, so I sacrificed the black part of the visor, it's hard to get into there, and I'll go back over that with some black. As you can see, it's okay to make mistakes. It's easy to fix them. Use the edge of our brush again and get some red over here. Just gonna cover it a little bit. And I'd like to have a little bit more black. This nose piece right here. And then on this side. Okay, it looks nice and clean. Let that dry and move on. Let's add the red to the top of the helmet. Just like that. Let's continue painting the red. Let's start with his chest here. It's a little hard to get on camera here. As you can see, I messed up and got red in the center, so I'll have to redo that. And I'm going to go back over the red when it dries and make some of the black markings. And it has this arrow on his boot. So I have these markings here on the shoulder. It's like an arrow. And this side as well. If you don't like, you know, what you've done, it's not completely, you know, accurate. We'll come back and go over it again. He also has this red edge highlighting here on his front pants. I'm going to assume it goes on the back as well. And then go back over his chest. With some more of the red. Looking pretty cool so far. Now that we have his red, let's paint some of his rocket launcher, jetpack here. I'm going to use the edge of my brush again. Okay. Let's pause there. We're going to use some Eagle Sun Scarlet and do a little bit of highlighting with the red. Just get a little bit on your brush. Come back up here to his mask. We're just going to do a little bit of the highlighting on top side. I have to start my timer, dang it. All right, we'll just keep the timer rolling. Brush a brush, and let's add a little bit of a yellow orange into that scarlet red. Just to show you on the wet palette here, took some of that bright yellow and added it over here to the Evil Sun Scarlet, make a nice orangish color. Gonna change brushes, get a lot smaller of a tip. I'm gonna go back over those same areas, just a little bit more. Just going to try and create this glare highlight here across the red. Make it pop a little bit more. Then add it to the shoulders here as well, kind of near the top. Just make it a little brighter. Use the edge of your brush. Can really see the water starting to come out here. Clean your brush here. Go back to using some of the black and gray mix and clean up our lines with a fine brush. And especially in here where the armor is on the chest piece. There's kind of a line coming in diagonally straight down like this. You can see that black line there. Do the opposite over here. And there's another larger line here. We're going to clean up this area on his bottom of his chest plate. Okay, there's his markings. I also have some of the black going up into the diamond here. This looks pretty good. Clean that brush off, so let's do a little bit more of the original red with some of the scarlet. And try to blend in the orange a little bit more. I can just take some yellow orange, the very edge here. Now we can go back over some of our lighter grays that we've had. Kind of clean these lines up a little bit. Looks better. Need to clean this line up a little bit more too. And his pants here. They're a little bit more lighter gray. I'm quite happy with where the red is at right now. It's hard to get the orange red on camera. Get some different light. Right, let's get some of our yellow and fix our middle of our chest piece here. We had a little mistake on our visor here. Let's grab some of your favorite silver, roofing steel. You can use whatever you like. I'm going to go over the belts, buckles. Go back over some of the horns on the helmet with some of the black here on the inside. get a little bit of the gray while we're at it and go over the gun. And use the edge of your brush and get the edges of the horns. Get some of the light gray here. And we're just gonna do a little bit of the edge highlighting here.
Thank you.
hit the tips of the horns, make them stand out a little bit more. All right, let's use some electric blue and add it in black. Put that on your wet palette. And I kind of mix them up to get this darker blue color. I'm gonna work on the shield. Ahead and just cover this entire shield in that dark blue color. And get a little bit of a brush. I'm going to be very careful not to splatter on your model here. I'm going to go thin as possible to wet your paint stand. You can do multiple coats if you need to. Get the other side. We'll let that dry. The shield has had time to dry. We're going to continue with our mix of colors here. I'm going to do a little bit more black blue now. Almost like a dark gray. We're going to get around here. Just in a circle. Not on the outer edge, but just going to build up our little gradient here. And do some back here as well. cloud to kind of mix it with the light blue again. And drag it towards the center in little lines. From this up, just grab some of your lighter blue and go back over the spots you don't like as much. Now go like straight for the black here and get as dark as you can. We're just kind of go in the middle again here. Now some of these kind of can go out towards the edges. Start my dang timer again. Grab some of your lighter blue and pull it in towards the center. Just random areas. That dry. Let's go ahead and use this lighter blue here. Put it on the wet palette. Get a small brush. Let's turn our timer back. You just kind of want to put it next to raised lines here. Just kind of in random spots. And you want to come around the edges. Like so. And if you want to darken up some of the spots again, come back in here and drag it back towards the center a little bit. can mix up your colors a little bit here. We want a nice variety of light blues and dark blues in here. Okay. Let's use some white scar. Any white will do. We're going to use the edge of our brush and get the raised parts of our shield here. And then we're going to get the edges of the shield. Just like there. And if you kind of want to go back over it with some of your lighter blue or darker blue, you can go back in here and kind of fix your mistakes if you have any. There we go. What you can do is dip your brush in some water and take your light blue color here. Just get a little bit of that on your brush, nice and wet. Once the white is dry, you can kind of go back over it a little bit. Kind of dull it down with your brush. Kind of like a wash a little bit. And this way, does it make it look as even in all the areas? And gives it some character. There's plenty of ways to do this. And if you get it too light in one spot, you can come back and darken it up a little bit. And if you want to do a little bit more edge highlighting, use the edge of your brush. Okay, let's call that good. Let's start with our base, Xandri Dust. Now, if you missed the basing video for the Shadow Collective, go ahead and go back and watch that. We're gonna just cover the entire base with the Xandri Dust here. Don't be afraid to apply a lot as we want to get down in the cracks. Now you don't have to because we're going to be doing some washing after this. We will let that dry and we'll come back. It's had time to dry now. Let's go ahead and add our Agrax Earthshade. Shake that up. And we're just going to apply it strictly to the base, just like with our previous videos for the Shadow Collective. Make sure your fingers are nice and dry. And just apply a nice liberal amount. All right, we'll let that dry. Oh, I forgot to start the timer. Well, we'll add a couple minutes there. Not even a minute. And we'll be back. All right. Let's use our white cigar and do some dry brushing. Get a brush that's nice and stiff and short with the bristles. Just dip it slightly into the paint. And grab some paper towel and just rub off as much as you can. And we'll get our base here. And if you're too worried, get some on your thumb. It'll start to show up here on the base how we'd like it. A little piece of off the base, but I can glue that back on. Okay, like where that's at, push pause. I decided to just leave that piece off and we'll cover it up with some Xandri dust. Dry brushing as well. Get off as much as you can here. And go to that spot where it was at and just kind of put your brush in a little bit more. And if you want to get some of the legs here, just a little dusty to blend it in. Feel free to go up higher. I'm going to kind of just keep it lower. And we'll call that good. Last thing to do is go around the rim of the base with some of our Abaddon Black. Load your brush up nice and thick. Make sure your hands are free from the dry brushing as we'll hold the model. And just make strokes back and forth. And that completes our model.